What I'm doing right now is I am painting our training space. This is so the cameras can calibrate each other and know what they're looking at, know the space that they're going to be tracking. We call this our tracking volume.
Serious Simulations is taking virtual reality training to the next level.
One of our guiding principles is to make our simulators as realistic as possible. And that realism requires them to have complete freedom of movement without wires, without artificial backpack computers. And that requires a very accurate tracking system.
There are 8 cameras mounted on 4 towers, and those are all routed to the computer, and the computer does software processing on the camera images in real time.
That tracks the human body, the positions of all the arms, hands, fingers, head, etc., and translates that in real time onto an avatar in the virtual world.
The company develops simulated training exercises for people doing dangerous jobs, including soldiers and first responders.
So the trainee sees himself by wearing a head-mounted display as the avatar in the 3D virtual world. And as he moves in the physical space, he sees that avatar move identically in the virtual world.
Where the touch, the feedback, even the smells is possible to add into the full immersion experience.
Therefore, he becomes immersed in that environment. It becomes natural feeling to be in that environment. And we achieve what we call a suspension of disbelief.
When they're in something real in their mind, you can often stress them out a bit. Positive stress is always good for higher levels of concentration and better training outcomes.
Chris's military experience proved invaluable in his new role with Serious Simulations.
I spent several years in the Army as an officer, and one of my final assignments was managing the creation of a video game which came to be known to the public as America's Army. We wanted to connect with young people through this fairly new venue of video games at the time and create a story about the Army, but by the Army.
Upon returning to civilian life, it was a natural transition to combine the latest technology in video games and military training.
But we took this attack of very high realism, unencumbered movement, 100% real equipment in the simulator, no wires. So those were kind of tall orders for us in the first 2 years.
Chris and his team received their first patent for a technology they call zero frame latency.
We did that so that we didn't add any more additional latency penalty, latency being the lag time that's involved between generating an image and its movement and having it displayed to the individual.
So this clear box is a demonstration of a head-mounted display in a box to make it absolutely visible of what's going on. So inside every HMD, or head-mounted display, there is a display screen, one or more of those, a battery, some electronics, and because this one is wireless, we also have a wireless receiver inside of this box.
And the beauty of this system is that all the electronics and tracking systems are actually in the visor. So as soon as he's finished, we can actually just remove the visor and attach it to the next person, attach it to the next person. So it's a very, very high throughput system.
All of these are central to making our technology work, creating the only wireless package for very wide field of view, high resolution displays out there.
The system also allows trainees to use their personal gear, adding another level of realism.
We have a saying here that if it's real, then it's right. And weapons for both police and for military are quite individualized now. In order to allow the soldiers to come into our simulator and train as close to reality as possible, we wanted them to come with their real weapon, not a fake toy weapon or a simulated weapon. We also allow the trainees to wear 100% of their real combat gear with some overlays for the simulation.
Chris knows the value of real-world experience firsthand and employs individuals who are on the same page.
I like employing veterans just because we have a common background, common experience, and I'd like to give back a bit by helping their transitions into civilian life. There's lots of opportunities, lots of careers within the military that translate very well into civilian sector jobs. And resetting your mind a bit and resetting your vocabulary and resetting your expectations as you exit the military can make it quite successful.
Watch full episodes of SciTech Central Thursdays at 8:30 p.m.